now to this, virtual immortality through AI. People are now using artificial intelligence to memorialize their loved ones. ABC's Melissa Adan takes a look at how this technology is creating conversations across generations and the concerns that are now coming with it.
Hello, Dad.
Stephanie Lucas O'Neill is talking to her dad, William Lucas. The thing is, he is no longer with us. William passed away last year.
One of the earliest memories that I have is arriving on a boat.
Stephanie is using Hereafter AI to honor her dad's legacy. The co-founder of Hereafter AI, James Vlahos, got the idea for the service when his own father was diagnosed with terminal cancer.
I realized there might be a different and more interactive way to share his story, and that gave me the idea to create what I call the Dadbot, which is an interactive voice and text chatbot that shares his stories and his personality for the family for generations to come.
This led to the more advanced version, Hereafter AI.
The voice that you hear is the actual recorded voice of the person who created the life story avatar.
A virtual biographer interviews the person about their life, recording the responses to create an avatar that loved ones down the road can access and talk to.
Would you like to hear more about this part of my life?
Well, the thing about this is somehow you kind of say to yourself, I'm not worthy. You know, like, who wants to hear this from me? But I think it's important that people know history from the people who live the history. And especially for Black Americans, we have so much of our history was just erased.
Though using this kind of technology doesn't come without concerns.
In my dad's case, he died before the whole process was complete. So they had to use voice synthesizers to bridge what he said. And it sounded just like my father. They could have made my father say anything.
Making sure the avatar is an accurate portrayal of the person is a priority for Vlahos. And at Hereafter AI, they never sell your data. Only the person and those they authorize can access their memories.
It does change how we grieve, but more importantly, it changes how we remember. I think some people fear that maybe this relates to not letting go of someone you loved or not leaving the grieving process. And the way I see it is like, well, yeah, I don't want to grieve forever, but I also don't want to forget.
Melissa Adan, ABC News, Los Angeles.
Well, there are a few companies using technologies like this one. Costs of creating an AI life story avatar range anywhere from free to $500 depending on the service and package. Access to the recordings also free, so long as you're an authorized user.